This pivot table is created from this data dump. Let's suppose we have got few more data and this data to be updated in this pivot table. So how to do it? Welcome to ASPC Excel guides. Let's add some data in this data dump. I will add all these 700 rows below the table. Copy and paste. Now, as I have doubled the data, hopefully the pivot table data will also be doubled. But it is not. To get the change effect, we need to refresh the data in the pivot table. There are two ways to refresh the pivot table data. Right click in the pivot table and choose refresh from the pop-up menu. Or you can go to the analyze tab under data. Click this refresh button or from the drop down list select and click the refresh option. But the data is not updated. Why? Because this pivot table didn't understand that the data has been updated. So we need to make the pivot table understood that the data range is increased. Under analyze tab, click this button, change data source. The drop down list opens, select and click the change data source option. This will lead you to the data source file or sheet. Please note, this is our source data in this sheet. The dotted lines is showing how many data this pivot table is accessing. We need to update the data range in this change data table pivot source. We have an option already selected. Select a table or range. If you press Ctrl Shift and down arrow, it will select the entire row below the dotted lines. Or you can delete this and manually select the range. Click OK. The data is updated now. Another solution to this is you can select the columns with data. In this case, it is from column A to column I column. But here is a small problem. We get another additional column as blank. Now you can deselect the blank column from the product drop-down list. It will solve the problem. And the benefit is that if you update your data, you don't need to worry about whether the data range is given to the pivot table or not. You update the data table and refresh the pivot table. We're done. Another method is to convert this data range into table. Use a shortcut. Press Ctrl and T to convert this data range into table. Please confirm that this tick box is selected before hitting OK button. Now you can convert table from this button also. Format as table. Click here. You see a number of formats. Choose any and click OK. The data range will be converted into table form. Now you can ask what is the difference between a table and a data range. I will discuss this in detail in another video. Please subscribe and click the bell to get the notification. Here we have converted the data range into table. Now if I copy all the data except column headers and paste it at below the existing data, and if I move to the bottom of the data, the newly appended data is showing under this table. How to understand that the data has been included in this table? You check for this small icon in the right side of this cell, which means this data is included in the table. Now go to the pivot table and right click and then click on refresh option, and the data is updated in the pivot table. Now let's suppose if I want to connect pivot table from any table from databases like Access or SQL Server or any other source. How to do it? This is a higher level pivot table. I will discuss later. In my next video, I will discuss how to apply conditional formatting to pivot table. Please like and click the subscribe button to get modern Excel tutorial notifications. Thank you for your interest.